I'm Lauren Fensterstock, and I'm here today to talk about my site-specific work in the exhibition Forces of Nature, the Renwick Invitational 2020 at the Renwick Gallery of the Smithsonian American Art Museum. My work in this exhibition is entitled The Totality of Time Lusters the Dusk. And I really wanted a kind of almost ridiculously grandiose title for this piece, because I think the piece itself is kind of poking at a magnificence beyond human comprehension. The piece centers around the appearance of a comet, and I'm really interested in comets. They're, you know, things that have appeared in important artworks like the Bayeux Tapestry, Giotto's paintings, over millennia. And they exist in this span kind of beyond human comprehension, you know, arcing around our universe for millions of years. But they're also just dirty snowballs. And there's something about this space between something that's so mundane and so just magnificent that I'm interested in, that those two things can actually be quite the same. There are two black mirrors that have been kind of captivating me for over a decade. One is the Claude glass, which was a 17th century invention used by amateur artists to observe the landscape. And the other is the scrying mirror, which is also a black mirror, which was used to divine the future. And actually the piece behind me, which is carved obsidian, is an example of a scrying mirror. And there's something about these two tools, one used to observe the world around us empirically, and the other used to try to touch a world that we can't know, we don't see. I feel like I'm somehow suspended between these two mirrors, and they've been at the center of my work for a long time. The whole landscape is rendered in black, and that's partly in response to my inspiration from the two mirrors that I mentioned earlier, the Claude glass and the scrying mirror. But there's something about the power of black. I think it's really a magical color. I think in the absence of light, we're able to see things that have always been there, but that we've been overlooking. It forces your eye to change, and you suddenly can become aware of subtleties of tone and form and sheen. And I'm really interested in that kind of close looking, because I think if there is a spirituality or a magic in this world, it's not one that's abstract, it's not one that's far away, it's one that's here all around us, and we just have to look a little bit closer to find it. It's such an honor to have my work at the Renwick Gallery and its strong connection to the crafts and decorative arts, which you know, is the field that I consider my home. The architecture is so symbolic, you know, this architecture that really is at the heart of the identity of America. And I think to see that architecture being interrupted, interacted, maybe even overwhelmed by the inexplicable forces of nature, I think says something about, you know, where we are as humans and Americans at this moment. If people can leave with the sense that they are suspended between a past and a future, I think that's important to me. And it doesn't absolve us of the ethics of our moment, but I think it helps us understand them in perspective and just the long unfolding of events, human, natural, animal, and mineral, and maybe cosmic.